Delhi police arrested Major Nikhil Nanda on Sunday from Meerut cantonment under the charges of Major Amit Dwivedi's 30-year-old wife Shalza's murder. Shalza's body was found in Delhi cantonment area on 23rd of June. Her throat was slit and to show it an accident, her body was run over by a car. Major Handa and Shalza Dwivedi, wife of Major Amit Dwivedi, met about 2 months ago in Nagaland where both the officers were working together. Ms. Dwivedi then moved to Delhi after her husband was transferred. Shalza had left home on 23rd June morning for a physiotherapy session at the Army Base Hospital in Delhi Cantonment. Major Handa picked her up in his Honda City car. After about half an hour, she was found dead. India will celebrate the first anniversary of Goods and Services Tax rollout in the country on 1st of July. As the historic and one of the biggest tax reform completes 1 year, the question is whether the GST stood for goods and simple tax or Gabbar Singh tax as termed by opposition. Prime Minister Narendra Modi termed it as an example of beauty and power of Indian democracy in which, forgetting all differences, all the states came together to create history. On Sunday, in his monthly radio address to the nation, Mann Ki Baat, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that the credit of remarkable success of GST goes to the states of our nation. This is a great example of cooperative federalism. PM said that before the onset of GST scheme, there were 17 different types of taxes in the country. GST is not only the victory of integrity, but it is also a celebration of honesty. Now, IT replaced the Inspector Raj and check posts have gone. 19 out of 25 dirtiest cities in India are from West Bengal. The list includes the cities like Darjeeling, Siliguri, Serampore, Madhyamgram, North Barrackpore, Bankura, etc. failed abysmally on all sanitation indicators like waste collection, open defecation, solid waste processing and disposal. Union Housing and Urban Affairs Ministry released the results of nationwide cleanliness survey of 500 cities with a population of over 1 lakh, in which Bhadreshwar in Gujarat remained at the bottom of the list. Three cities each from Bihar and Uttar Pradesh are also among the dirtiest, figuring in the bottom of the list. For the first time, all cantonment boards run by the army were also included in the survey. Jharkhand is the cleanest state in India, followed by Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh. According to the survey report of Union Housing and Urban Affairs Ministry, which was released by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Indore on Saturday. Among the cities, Indore is the cleanest second year in a row, followed by Bhopal and Chandigarh. Prime Minister also gave away the award to cleanest states and cities at a function. Varanasi, Prime Minister Modi's parliamentary constituency, was ranked 29th among the list of 500 cities. Last year, it was ranked 32. BJP Chief Amit Shah on Saturday justified the party's decision to walk out of Mehbooba Mufti government and accused the PDP of ignoring the interest of Jammu and Ladakh. He said that Prime Minister Modi sent crores of rupees for the development of the state, but the PDP government ignored the interest of Jammu and Ladakh, so we decided to quit the government. Amit Shah attacked both the People's Democratic Party and the National Conference, saying that two families from NC and PDP ruled Jammu Kashmir for three generations, but they served only their personal interests and not of the state. The BJP chief was addressing a rally to mark historic martyrdom anniversary of Jan Sangh founder Shyama Prasad Mukherjee. Shah praised Shyama Prasad Mukherjee for integrating Kashmir with India. A video which showed Anushka Sharma reprimanding Arhan Singh for throwing plastic out of his car's window has invited legal trouble for the Bollywood star and Indian cricketer Virat Kohli. Arhan Singh, the man who was earlier told off by the Bollywood actor for littering Mumbai roads, sent a legal notice to Anushka and Virat on Saturday for shaming him on social media. According to a few party leaders, Bharatiya Janata Party will appoint an in-charge for each of the 543 Lok Sabha segments and set up a 11-member committee in every state to start preparations for the next year's parliamentary elections. These in-charge or prabhari will be formed outside Lok Sabha constituency, which they'll oversee. The 11-member panel will be called Chunav Tayari Toli and will look after 13 specific assignments related to the state. This is for the first time that BJP has appointed an in-charge for every Lok Sabha seat, a model that Bahujan Samaj Party has been following for years. Virat Kohli led Team India is scheduled to play two T20s against Ireland on 27th and 29th of June. That would be followed by three T20s, three ODIs and five test matches against England starting from 3rd of July. After arrival, India's opening batsman Shikhar Dhawan shared a video where he can be seen singing a song for Virat Kohli and Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Mere Do Anmol Ratan, Ek Ram To Dooja Lakhan. Dhawan was heard singing in the video while panning the phone camera towards Dhoni and Kohli. The Indian team is scheduled to play two T20s against Ireland on 27th and 29th, and that would be followed by matches against England. The German police said that 25 people have been injured, out of which 4 are serious, when an explosion destroyed a building in the western city of Wuppertal. Police said that the explosion rocked the several-story building shortly before midnight Saturday with a large noise, scaring people in surrounding homes so much that they ran out into the street in a panic. The police told that they were still trying to get the fire under control and are investigating the cause for the explosion.